We're based out of, actually, south of Birmingham, about 13 miles, okay. A place called Chelsea.
All right.
So we put him on a bike, and we actually restricted him. We forced him into the cross-country world, made him kind of stay with his wheels on the ground as long as possible. But it was actually about a year and a half ago that we truly went, all right, baby, do the things you love. Wherever we go to, either it's Colorado or Arkansas or Tennessee, you know, even in those competitive environments, he's still establishing friendships.
He has this mentality, like, it's not like just a sport where just like football or baseball, it's a lifestyle, like, and he lives that lifestyle with me.
Nika's kind of fueling kids to bikes, but the kids that are in Nika that have been on bikes are looking for something else now, and they're progressing and pushing the limits. And it's kind of neat now. What we're starting to do is kind of reaching out to people, and we're all meeting up, you know, either staying the night before or the night after, in between, and riding Wind Rock one day, then run over to Baker's Creek Preserve and playing on the jumps over there. I think the last time we were there, there was people from four different states that met up to ride together. You know, we found the ultimate, you know, pimp palace when it comes to the Quest Hotel outside of Knoxville.
Yeah.
It's a rundown indoor water park hotel.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. $50 a night. That's our meeting place now. It gets expensive. I think we put 30,000 miles on the old minivan this past summer, between racing and then just having fun, because we try to find balance. Other sports, kind of conventional sports, you know, you become a soccer mom, baseball dad, or football, you don't play. With bicycling, man, you're out there with them. You're doing it with them. It's a group thing. You might not be out there on the race course with them, but when you're training or traveling, having fun on the different places you go, you're out there with them on the bike.
Yeah.
Like when we're out on the trail, nothing before matters. We could be in the biggest fight we've ever had, and we go out and ride, and it's like nothing happened.
And that's what I love. You know, it's a sport that we do together. It's not individualized. It's not him and other people. It's us. So, and I like that side. A lot of the parents that we interact with also ride as well. I might not do the stupid drops that he does and jumps, but I do like to pedal. And it got to the point where, you know, there's everybody waits, you know, there's two different points that we stop, wait for dad, and so on. There's certain things that he feels that I can do that I don't let myself do, but I always, you know, I always have to tell him that I'm the one that actually has to drive home. He's not 16 yet. What's neat to see is where, say, football, baseball, or some of these other things, they do go drop off. Well, I mean, we have friends now, like Lily and her mother. Lily's 18 years old. Her mom still travels with her. A mommy, you know? Chris, his stepfather, he's 18, still travels with them. And it's awesome. These kids have chosen to still be with their parents and their loved ones and hang out with them all weekend long. It's just a great environment. To me, it's such a, it fosters just that family strength of things. Progressionary-wise, in the free ride gravity downhill, I mean, he's up there. He's fast, he's getting more comfortable. It seems to be progress every weekend, and that's why we constantly keep going. We're constantly moving, giving him opportunities to train and learn and be around faster kids. What's great is, man, I'm looking at, I think that's a 50-year-old guy down to, there's a little 10-year-old running around here, so.
Yeah.
I like hitting that double up there.
It was actually on a stage 3 pre-ride for Red Star. It was a wet day. He actually wore his half shell that day, just based on humidity and stuff, and grabbed one of the locals and bombed it down with him and hit some wet rocks and ended up on his face. Actually, when I got up to him, I thought he actually tore his eyelid off because all I saw was white. After washing it off, he had a big cut, some bruises all over his chest. What was bad, it was a 2.5-hour walkout.
The love and care he shows for me, like when we're at the races, like a lot of parents push their kids to do things that they don't want to do. Like, he knows when I can do something and he's like, you need to hit this, like you can do it. But when there's things like that other kids are hitting that I might not be ready for or that might seem dangerous, he's chill about it. He's not like, you have to do this, it's okay to avoid something sometimes.
And actually, I mean, we do that. I mean, when we free ride, there's certain levels, you know, like Boulder Ridge where he likes to play and stuff like that. That is a full face day. Because if it goes wrong, he's gonna eat 30 feet of rock. No, one thing I would say to BB, I mean, I love him every day.
Yeah, yeah. So here
I'm his biggest, I'm his biggest advocate. You know, I love what he does. You know, I've seen him at his worst, and I've seen him the happiest. So the past 5.5 years after his accident, I've seen every aspect of him, the good, the bad. You know, from fighting to loving to crying to everything. So one thing is, you know, after the accident, he kind of lost that smile and that happiness that he got out of the motocross community. And over the past 2 years, I've seen that smile again. There's pictures of him, you know, that I've posted that, man, that sparkles in his eye and that smile's killer, man. He loves this community, and I mean, we love it as a family.
I have a lot of anxiety, but at the same time, when I ride, I'm able to just chill. And I feel like a lot of sports, people don't just do for fun. It's always like a game or a competition. Like here.
Keeping score.
Yeah. Here I can, like today, I'm just hitting jumps. It's all I've been doing today, and I love it so much, and I have no stress.
Yeah.
There's a purpose why we race.
Yeah.
And it's just educating people about, you know, traumatic brain injuries, the dark side of things that come along with that, depression, anxiety, and so on, and getting people to talk and communicate. BB likes to kind of share what he's gone through.
Just that I love him. I love him so much. Like, he does so much for me. But besides the physical things, he cares for me. And, like, he knows who I am, which is nice.
A lot of neat things happening. Some great partnerships inside and outside the biking community. I bet you have to get used to when they fall and scrape themselves and hurt themselves. Have a stomach for it.
There's some tough love in there.
There is.
There's some tough love that's going to happen.
Quit crying. Get up.
Yeah, you'll be all right. Rub some dirt.
Put some dirt on it.
Put some dirt on it.